You know what's weird? The Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle series of video games is very odd, and it's mostly not because of the games themselves, because to be quite honest, while I kind of like these games, they're very simplistic and kind of mediocre. Like, not really mediocre, but they get kind of monotonous and dull, because it's the same thing for, like, a lot of levels. But it's okay, because it's got that weird kind of old-school arcade kind of feel to it, where the gameplay is very simplistic, the game's very simplistic, but it's still kind of fun, but not something epic or anything. But what's weird about them is that these games do not star Bugs Bunny in every region. And the only reason they starred Bugs Bunny in America in the first place was because of copyright reasons. We'll start with the first one, the game on the NES, the original Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle. And, you know, it says Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle, not Bugs Bunny's Crazy Castle, because, you know, fuck grammar. What was the Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle here in America was actually in Japan a Who Framed Roger Rabbit video game. Right, based on the 80s movie that is still an amazing marvel of animation, live-action hybrid to this very day. When it was to be brought to America, they couldn't make it Who Framed Roger Rabbit because LJN had the rights to Who Framed Roger Rabbit in America, and they and Rare made the American Who Framed Roger Rabbit game. Is that better or worse than Crazy Castle? I would say it's arguable. I think Crazy Castle is a better game overall, but the LJN Rare game feels like it's based on Who Framed Roger Rabbit, which Crazy Castle really doesn't. It just feels like a generic game with Roger Rabbit characters. So generic of a game, in fact, that they were able to bring it to America, slap the Bugs Bunny characters on there, and, you know, nobody knew. It just worked. I guess this is why Invisible Ink is the invincibility item.
Acme disappearing, reappearing ink!
So yeah, that's the first game. It didn't have a release in Europe, seemingly, so there wasn't yet another weird version of it. Also, why the fuck is Sylvester a bad guy in this game when, you know, Marvin the Martian or Elmer Fudd aren't used, but Sylvester is? I mean, I understand Yosemite Sam and Wile E. Coyote,
super genius,
and Daffy Duck being bad guys, because, yeah, they're antagonists to Bugs quite often, but Sylvester? Not just Sylvester, but multiple versions of Sylvester, multiple colors of Sylvester, Rainbow Sylvester. I think this Sylvester is really sick. But yeah, no, he's just a weird choice, I guess. Holy shit, Wile E. Coyote looks like he's buffed up. What the fuck? Wile E. Coyote, super gymnast. So, the next Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle game we got was on the Game Boy, and it was also just named the Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle. But in Japan, this game starred Mickey Mouse. However, when they tried to bring that to America, guess what? Capcom has the rights to make Disney games in America, so they couldn't use Mickey Mouse here, so guess what? It's Bugs Bunny again! And this one did get released in the PAL region, or, you know, Europe. Then there was the Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle 2 on Game Boy. Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle 2 in Japan was Mickey Mouse 2. In Europe, though, it got two different ports. Some of them used Mickey Mouse, and some of them used a character called Hugo, which I am very unfamiliar with. He's some sort of Danish character. It looks like a troll or something. But then those two Mickey Mouse games on Game Boy, Mickey Mouse and Mickey Mouse 2, got re-released in Japan as the Bugs Bunny Collection, which were the same games, just with the Bugs Bunny characters for some reason. What the fuck, Kim? Go get that extra money by releasing the exact same game with just a graphic change. Now this game series kind of splits off weirdly, where, like, in Japan they started making different Mickey Mouse games that aren't Bugs Bunny related games, but they're still considered continuations of the Mickey Mouse series. There's this NES game called Mickey Mouse 3 Balloon Dream. So it got changed to Kid Clown in Nightmare World in America, which was the start of a Kimco kind of mascot character named Kid Clown. So next on the list is Mickey Mouse 4, which of course was not able to be released as Mickey Mouse in America, and I guess Europe either, because in America it got released as the real Ghostbusters of all things. The most unfitting possible thing you could have strapped to this. So, okay, you changed Mickey Mouse to Peter Venkman. Sure. Why not? And then in Europe, it got released as Garfield's Labyrinth. I'm very confused by this. Why didn't you just, if you're going to use an, it's an American license. Why didn't you just make both of them Garfield or both of them the real Ghostbusters? I don't get it. And Garfield fits a lot better in this game than Peter Venkman does. It's so strange. So weird. Why the real Ghostbusters? I don't even think that show was still on TV when this game was released. So next was Mickey Mouse 5, Maha No Stick. It got released in America as a Mickey Mouse game, finally. So now, get to the next Bugs Bunny game. Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle 3 for Game Boy and Game Boy Color. It was like that in both America and Europe. But in Japan, it got released twice. Once as Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle 3, and once as Go Go Kid Tsuruyuki Kid Go Go Kid. Which I guess translates to Let's Go Kid Go Go Kid. Anyways, it stars Kid Clown. So now we get the Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle 4 for Game Boy Color. And guess what? It's released that everywhere. Finally, we've got a Bugs Bunny game completely across the board. Except for after this game, Kimco lost the Bugs Bunny license. After making Bugs Bunny games from 1989 to 2000, they lost the license. So what did they do for the fifth Crazy Castle game? They slapped Woody Woodpecker on there. Everybody's favorite animated psychopath. Seemingly based loosely on the Woody Woodpecker 90s cartoon, I think. Even though this would have come out, I think, after that show ended. So, yeah, and it's Woody Woodpecker Crazy Castle 5 across the board. Also, unlike the Bugs Bunny games where they kept slapping all the characters in it, seemingly this one is Woody Woodpecker against a bunch of generic enemies, which I find really weird. Because it's like, why didn't you just, I don't know, put Wally Walrus and Buzz Buzzard into this game to make it more authentic? Anyways, yeah, Woody Woodpecker Crazy Castle 5. I've never played this one, but it uses weird kind of 3D models and it looks honestly kind of shitty. Seemingly there's a Crazy Castle mobile phone game that got released in 2004. The mobile phone version just has generic characters in it, and I can't find very many screenshots of it of any good quality. Like, look at this. I can't tell what anything in this picture is. You could have told me this is a Mary-Kate and Ashley Olsen game and I would have believed you. This looks bad. Wow, you couldn't even get a license to put on it this time. You just put generic characters. You didn't even put Kid Clown on here. You could have put Kid Clown. You own him. But yeah, that's the whole thing. That is the history. That is Bugs Bunny's Crazy Castle in a nutshell. This series is all over the place with licenses. We had Roger Rabbit. We had Bugs Bunny because seemingly swapping out one rabbit is good for another. We got Mickey Mouse. We got Hugo. Whatever the fuck this thing is. We got the real Ghostbusters. And Garfield. And we end with Woody Woodpecker. I guess technically we end with generic girl. I think it's a girl. I can't really tell. You know what? I'm not going to count that one. We're just going to end with Woody Woodpecker because, yeah, why not?